What's going on, everybody? Here we are in my 1995 Subaru Impreza. This is the third time I've tried to record this video. I just had a couple of issues, but I'm working through it. But anyway, this is it. I was asked a question about my head unit, my audio system in the car. It's the stock speakers in the car. Only the rears work. The fronts have never worked since I've owned the car. Previous owner problems. Yeah, I don't really know what the deal is, but I only have back speakers in here for now. Obviously, we're going to put new speakers in here, like updated, like, you know, not 30-year-old speakers. And hopefully it'll sound really nice. But for now, we're just going to go over it. My car is not on. That's why I have all the dash lights. Just the key is on. So this is the head unit. It's an NEX 1400. It's by Pioneer. And we bought this head unit because it has CarPlay. It was originally in my wife's 2013 Impreza Sport. And then when we sold that car, I ended up just throwing it in here because the radio in here was kind of an excuse for a radio. It was just kind of like hanging around until we did something else with it. So I just ended up putting it in here. And it's changed, obviously, the entire experience of driving the car, you know, because you get GPS and all that fun stuff. So that's kind of like my radio head unit deal. So hopefully that answers your question. I was asked yesterday what head unit I used. Very easy to install. You don't really need like an install kit or anything. You just need one for the wiring harness. It's just a couple of bolts. After you take this out, which slides out really easy. There's a couple bolts behind there. Getting the automatic shifter is easy. There's just two screws and it slides up. With this, you just pop it up and twist it out. It's not really a big deal. So hopefully that'll help you if you have the automatic transmission. Sadly, we still have the auto in this. I have the manual transmission literally sitting right in front of the car under that tarp. You know, sad to say. Sorry, my yard's a little bit of a mess. We're kind of in the middle of a bunch of stuff, especially with the trees. You know, we're trying to get these trees out of here. So, yeah. Anyway, so that is the head unit I have. Yeah, I mean, it's great. So that kind of gives you an idea. You got your phone and everything on there. You got GPS. You've got, you know, everything you can think of that you would need. Apple CarPlay. It's wonderful. It's not wireless. Mine's wired, but I charge my phone anyway when I'm in the car typically. So having it plugged in for CarPlay is not really a big deal for me. Some people were going to really prefer the wireless. For me, the wired one's a little bit more instant. You're not waiting on a delay, getting in the car, waiting for it to connect. It's just, you plug it in and you're done. So anyway, that's that. I'm going to go over a couple little small things outside and then let's see where we're at now. Obviously, okay, so we're still recording. The last time I did this video, I plugged in to the radio and it shut it off. So, all right. Yesterday, when I was recording this video, I had mentioned that I was getting some scraping on the power steering rack. So, if you have that power steering rack, the PRS quick rack, it's an amazing steering rack, but there you do scrape if you have like 15-inch wheels. I don't know that you would have the same issue if your car was still like factory ride height. Mine's a little bit lower than factory because of the iBox springs. But also, I have 15-inch wheel. If you had a 17 or 18-inch wheel, it might not even be an issue. But for me, I have the 15-inch wheels, so it is an issue where I get rubbing at full lock, which I try not to do full lock very often, but sometimes it really depends on the geometry of how the car is going down, you know, an embankment or whatever, or how quickly I'm turning, and they'll scrape the inner wheel, and that's not fun. So you need to get something like this. This is the GC8 STI aluminum control arm, and make sure you get that little acorn in there where the tape is. I don't know if you can see that, but if you don't have that little piece, these are useless. So yeah, those are completes. I got those. I've had them for a couple of years. Just another thing that I have to install that I've had, kind of like my transmission over here. Sorry for the mess. And then the other thing that I have that I need to install are these brand new, or I should say freshly refreshed, 4-pot brakes. Now, obviously they are a ton bigger than the factory brakes, and the rotor is quite larger too. So, yeah, that's another issue that we're going to be dealing with. They bolt right in, especially since I have those new braided lines and all that. They bolt right in. It's just a matter of getting the shields and stuff out of the way, or buying new shields, which I plan to do. And then these are the rears. These are not necessarily a bolt-in option. You actually have to have an adapter or the correct backing plate, which I have the adapter, so we're probably just going to go ahead and cut this backing plate. Or I would actually really like to get the original backing plate for it eventually, because, you know, I like it to be OEM fresh for the most part. So anyway, that is that for this video. I hope it helps you all in your endeavors with your GC projects. I mean, mine's not the nicest, cleanest, best that I have ever seen, but, you know, it's been a fun car, and I'm really just making these videos to help you guys out and hopefully build your own. Hopefully you get to enjoy the car like I do. So thanks for tuning in to another video, and I'll talk to you guys soon. If you have any more questions, just let me know and I'll shoot another video. I don't mind doing these.